They're normally blooming in
the fall.
In the fall, yeah. So.
Noreen Smith has essential tremor disorder, a neurological condition which makes daily activities like writing or drinking a glass of water almost impossible. She remembers getting the diagnosis at age 33.
I was devastated. I thought, I have no hope, you know, of getting better.
But now there is hope. Health Canada and the FDA have approved a revolutionary treatment for moderate to severe essential tremor that isn't responding to medication. It's called MRI-guided focused ultrasound. Patients are fitted with a specialized helmet, co-developed at Sunnybrook, which helps aim ultrasound waves precisely to the area of the brain causing the tremor. The heat generated at the focal point burns the affected tissue, immediately alleviating symptoms. Dr. Nir Lipsman is co-author of a new study in the New England Journal of Medicine, which found this scalpel-free surgery is both effective and safe.
There was almost a 50% reduction in the most commonly used tremor rating scale in patients. So this for us demonstrated a significant benefit.
All right, so here we go. This first one's a quick one.
He says the treatment was also found to improve quality of life for patients who often withdraw socially and lose their ability to do things they used to enjoy. On the day of her treatment, Noreen is first asked to draw a spiral and write her name. She's then fitted with a frame that locks onto the helmet inside the MRI. Her medical team pinpoints the areas of the brain to target, delivering high-frequency ultrasound to a precise region of the brain over a three-hour period. Noreen is awake during the procedure, providing real-time feedback on her progress, which is quickly clear to see. After a few hours, she tries again to draw a spiral and write her name, and the results are dramatic.
This is half full of water, okay? Let's try to take a sip of that.
This is amazing. I couldn't do that before.
When's the last time you could do that?
30 years ago. A long time ago.
Dr. Lipsman says this technology could have future implications for other conditions like Parkinson's disease, depression, and Alzheimer's disease. And when it comes to Noreen's future plans, she's looking forward to doing all the little things she couldn't do before.
I wouldn't be able to sign my husband's card for our 50th anniversary, which is coming up at the end of the year. Okay. I feel like getting up and doing an arrest.
With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.